Let's face it, we hope that the world will continue for many thousands of years, but there's not necessarily thousands of years of energy out there.
Energy would be what makes the world turn.
Energy is everywhere.
All energy eventually goes to heat. Someplace down the line, it all falls into heat.
Energy moves us, and everything we do involves energy.
It's the result of work or heat transfer.
We use it for lighting, we use it for heating, we use it to drive our automobiles, to fly planes, move trains.
Without it, we're not going to have any of the conveniences that we think of as normal. And our cars wouldn't run, we wouldn't have lights in the room, we wouldn't have anything. So it's really what, you know, the world operates on.
Five years ago, we decided that energy would be a good program, particularly energy systems. There wasn't much of anything in the country at the time.
We started our first students in fall of 2010. This was in response to the nation's interest in energy issues.
I joined the program because I always wanted to be an engineer. My dad's an engineer, and this is a very special program. It's only offered in four other schools around the world.
It is relatively new. It's just been on the books for a couple years. So some of the more senior classes we're still developing. We have great faculty.
I think the students really appreciate the hands-on approach to what Ferris offers. We address theory, but we don't dig into it to a point where it dilutes the practical knowledge of this university.
The program has a basis or foundation in mechanical engineering technology and electrical engineering technology. Those disciplines relate a lot to energy, and they also have specialized courses in energy.
They're going to have knowledge in both areas, and they'll be able to tie it together for some of the energy systems. It could be designing different components, it could be working in a manufacturing area, it could be possibly for the government, it could be power distribution.
Well, I've been fortunate to have the opportunity to bring these students down to the power plant to have them learn what a gas turbine generator is.
Energy is going to be an issue with us for a long time, if not forever, unless we find something that's going to make a lot of electricity for free for us, and so far we're not close to that.
Energy efficiency is going to be the first thing that we have to fix, and then we can go into alternative energy.
It all comes down to understanding what is energy. You know, it's ability to do work.
But the need is there all over West Michigan, all over Michigan, nationally. You look at what we're trying to do with energy, oil, natural gas. It's not just alternative energy. We're starting to see companies come to us asking for our students. I had one in yesterday that is positioning themselves to be number one in North America, and they hired 250 people last year, and they're looking to hire our students now this upcoming years.
If I was able to pick, I would work with geothermal energy. I want to be able to do, you know, different cleaner renewable energy with more efficiency, you know.
There's a lot of interest in energy, and we're not sure what the jobs are going to be. There were several companies at the job fair. Great Lakes Energy is looking for interns this summer. Consumers Power, DTE, is interested in our graduates.
There will be some challenges here in the not too distant future because the cost of electricity is going to start to rise more and more as our coal fire systems become more expensive to operate.
Sources of energy, traditional ones, are going to become more scarce. That's inevitable at some point.
Everything we do involves energy, whether it's to create power or just to, you know, a transfer of things from place to place, it all requires energy.
You got a real passion for it. You want to get all the tools and information you can and education you can. And that's where the program can come in and get the student an opportunity to really get his hands into what's going on out there.